UK shares opened higher at the start of trade today in line with other equity markets around the world as investors put aside lingering concerns about the US stimulus policy and Chinese money market rates. In among some of the small caps are watching, Sirius Minerals was on the move. It's in good shape actually after the potash development company said it's signed a 1 million ton 10-year offtake agreement with a Chinese company for the polyhalite it'll produce at its York potash project. Sirius said the offtake is for fixed price over the first 3 years of the contract, with the potential to renegotiate terms from year four. President Energy, another gainer after unveiling some encouraging news from its Puesto Guardian concession in Argentina. It said its Dos Puntitas field well is flowing at 490 barrels a day of oil and injection water, with a 70% cut of crude and rising. It's the first of three wells to be hydraulically stimulated, and the gross flow rate represents a fivefold increase on projection before the action was taken. On the results front, investors welcome positive earnings from Rambler Metals and Mining. It reported a second quarter of profit as its momentum as a commercial producer continues. The gold and copper miner reported a Q3 profit of $193,000 against a loss of almost $400,000 this time last year, and said the period was notable for a milestone breakthrough at its flagship Ming mine. Richland Resources is finding the going more tough, though. The company warned illegal mining took a heavy toll on its Tanzanite operation over the past 12 months and had also badly hit the current year. Neighbouring miners tunnelling into Richland's operations put restrictions on where the company could operate, as well as leading to the loss of a significant amount of high-grade Tanzanite. Revenues in 2012 fell to 20%. To $20.5 million and alongside a $4.4 million impairment charge for the illegal mining and $5.6 million unpaid South African taxes meant a net loss for the year of $13.6 million. Elsewhere, Decal Oil Chairman Andrew Tillery said he's highly confident the palm oil group will be revenue generating next year. The update to be given at the company's annual meeting reveals the building of its 60-ton per hour extraction mill in Côte d'Ivoire is progressing to plan. In other news, Brazil-focused nickel explorer Horizonte Minerals has set up an £8 million equity facility with investment group Henderson's Darwin Strategic Division. And finally, some big changes on the board of CGM Resources, the Bangladesh-focused coal company, 29.8% owned by Polo Resources. Polo's co-chairman, Michael Tang, joins GCM as chairman, while Neil Herbert and Guy Elliott, also at Polo, come on board as non-executives. Gary Lai, while remaining chief executive of GCM's subsidiary, Asia Energy Corporation, has stepped down as a director of the company. Let's look at some of the stocks on the move on this Thursday.